The still president, Donald Trump, gave his first press conference since losing the election. He was in the Oval Office and it was a day near to the days where he suffered losses in Pennsylvania as the Supreme Court threw out the final contestation of that election from the Trump team. Wisconsin recounts in multiple counties showed that Joe Biden won. In fact, he won by a little bit more than he originally had been counted to win. And Trump was asked about whether he will concede and about when the Electoral College does vote, if he will actually concede. Let's go to that side.
Just to be clear, if the Electoral College votes for Joe Biden, will you concede?
Well, if they do, they made a mistake because this election was a fraud. Just so you understand, this election was a fraud. I mean, they have Biden beating Obama on Obama's vote in areas that mattered in terms of the election in swing states. No, I can't say that at all. I think it's a possibility. They're trying to look between you people. Don't talk to me that way. You're just a lightweight. Don't talk to me that way. I'm the president of the United States. Don't ever talk to the president that way.
I mean, not for long. Like, are you though?
That's how presidents talk, by the way. That's exactly it. They're like my third grade teacher when someone pees on the carpet. That's
right.
It.
Excuse That's me, did you ask for a hall pass? Did you ask for a hall pass? Well, don't look at me like that. I can't do anything.
The only petulant thing he didn't do is pronounce the R in president like a W. Talk to me, I'm the president.
But so clearly he's upset. Clearly he knows all of his legal cases are imploding before his very eyes. But there was one detail of this press conference, and you might have seen it in that little clip, which is that his arms were strangely high, that his elbows were a little bit high up on that desk. And that is because that desk was tiny, a weensy little desk. Look at this photo, and it's just comically small. Like the flag behind him seems to be bigger than the desk itself. His knees seem to be touching like the top of the desk. His elbows are just like raised as he's, you know, continuing to say it's fraud. And that soon became the story of his first press conference back after this loss, right? Is that the tiny desk. So many a fun meme. We have a play school meme. Yes, Diaper Don with signable executive orders. My first border wall. I love it. A couple of others. Brett, you tweeted one out that was
Yeah, Brett went a little crazy with the Photoshop this weekend. So this is one. I always thought it looked like he was sitting on a toilet. So I added a toilet and what I assume would be his toilet paper holder. And then this other one, just to accentuate how much he looked like a kid at a birthday party asking for a crayon so he could fill out his coloring book. What an insanely petulant schmuckle. It's his first press conference where he took questions. I need to remind everybody, it isn't his first press appearance. His first press appearance was a 1 minute appearance to brag that the stock market rallied to 30,000 after it was pretty much assured that he would lose.
I haven't been on since that happened. Like, we're just clearly not in the same reality. Whereas like the Republicans are like, you see, huzzah. And you're like, yeah. The day that the transition office was like, fine, you can use the money that we have to bring in Biden. Like that was the moment that the stock market rallied, was when it was clear this administration would most likely leave.
Yeah, it's so true. And we all have problems with the stock market being like, yeah, same old, same old. That's a separate discussion from this one.
Sure.
And when you say like, they're trying to deny reality. That's it. That's the strategy, is to insulate everyone from the reality. What realities? Realities that like right now, sorry, someone honked at me but realities like the one that says that, listen, the Democrats wanna give, I don't care what the party name is, but the Democrats wanna get you COVID stimulus and the Republicans want you to say, well, this is all just a power grab from the Democrats. What?
Yeah,
grab that power if $1,200 makes its way to the bank accounts of people who can't buy food right now.
Yes, absolutely. Well, soon after this press conference, there was a trending hashtag. And that is because for those who zoomed in or got this press conference from a different angle and watching just how the president was seated at his tiny desk in his tiny chair, it appeared that he could only sit there, or that the chair itself accentuated a certain portion of his body that we've been talking about for a little bit of time because it looks extra stuffed. The hashtag diaper Don, y'all, was trending because as you can see there, if you can see, for those of you who saw this, Trump's booty was protruding, okay? His booty was protruding and it was sticking out of the little coattails of his jacket. And it was just on swole, okay? It was, he got a thickie, and I'm just gonna say it. And I don't know whether it's natural or whether he's using something to stuff it. And ergo, diaper Don started massively trending. And as you all know, hashtag show me the undies. If he actually doesn't wear diapers, just show us your big boy pants. That was a perfect excuse for me to tweet that. But Trump did take notice that diaper Don was trending and himself tweeted, Twitter is sending out totally false quote trends that have absolutely nothing to do with what's really trending in the world. Yes, they make it up and only negative quote stuff. Same thing will happen as Twitter, as is happening to Fox News daytime. Also big conservative discrimination. I mean,
is big conservative discrimination what he calls his booty? Maybe that's it. But I didn't believe it. I think Stephen Miller stuffed inside that waistline. and after this press conference, that's how he punishes people on his staff. After the press conference, you just hear from behind him emerge going, oh God, it was so terrible in there.
But I loved it.
I can't believe how big his butt is. So it's not fair to do this to Trump. We can see that, like, he's a tall guy. Here's what's frustrating. It's like someone who is so obsessed with looks. Like he casts people in his administration based on whether they would pass central casting.
Yes.
He has his hair done just so as a branding initiative. And he wears his ties really long to like elongate his torso. Who knows? But the one thing it is very clear he doesn't want you to see is just how ginormous his butt is. Like the only way I can get my knees that high on the toilet is when I'm using the squatty potties. And he looks like he's in a squatty potty. So insane. He's like, it's a lot easier. And he's covered America in feces. That's essentially what's happened.
Yeah, and it, granted, we've all been babies. We all remember what it was like. Anyone who has a dirty diaper is gonna be in a bad mood. So like I'm trying to also like relate to that, remember what it was like, knowing that maybe one day I will be back in depends. Hey. but like, you know, we will all be there. But like, yes, this is someone who's obsessed with his image. And hey, it's fun to once in a while dunk on this authoritarian fascist who lost handily and who refuses to accept reality and who single-handedly destroyed our democracy. But it wasn't too strong to begin with. So hey, Twitter had a field day. Trump got mad. I say it's news. What of it, y'all?
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.